Good morning, Mike. Good morning, Senator Sonny.
Good morning,
Attorney Galia. Let me begin with you. So Isambayan announced its nominees on Saturday afternoon, but within hours, two of them, Senator Grace Poe and Batangas Representative Vilma Santos Recto, said they have no plans of running for the presidency next year. And there's doubt as to two others, Sibak Party List Representative Eddie Villanueva and human rights lawyer Chal Jocno, if they are interested in running at all. So what happened here, sir? What was the nature of the talks with these nominees?
Well, I think, Mike, kailangan linawin lang natin. No? When you say you don't have plans, klaro naman po yun na I think sabi namin we... You want to think things over, then of course that is of course part of their decision. We respect it, and it's a personal decision really whether to run or not. But what is clear is all the message and all that was told to us, even privately or publicly through media, was that they agree to the unified efforts of Isambayan. They also agree that we should only have one candidate, and that unity is the way to have or to win in 2022. But I thank and I congratulate Senator Sonny in his steadfast desire, no? Openness, no? Kumbaga, ang isang bayan ay tumayo at nagbigay ng pahayag at kasama rin po si Senator Sonny sa pagtayo. Siguro, this really is a time of courage, no? Sa banda ng oposisyon. At kasama ho din namin yan si Senator Sonny sa paglaban dito po sa administrasyon at pagbigay po, more importantly, pagbigay po ng mas magandang hinaharap at kinabukasan sa mamamayang Pilipino.
Attorney Calia, just to clarify, so which among the nominees who have already said that they have no plans or are not interested in running, which among them do you think will eventually change their mind?
Well, of course, hindi ko po masabi yan, Mike, if they will change their mind or something. But when you say you don't have any plans, hindi naman po sinasabing hindi naman po sila sasama o hindi naman po sila sumusuporta sa proseso. So I think we just have to clarify that. Tama-tama po, when we finalize the list, at sabi ko nga, everything now is very fluid. Some might think it's time, some might think it's still early, pero fluid po. So tingnan po natin ang mga kaganapan or things that will happen in the days and weeks to come.
Okay. Now, with respect to Representative Vilma Santos Recto, she said she's not running for both the presidency and the vice presidency. But Senator Grace Poe just said she's not running for president. In your talks, is she open to running for vice president?
I think we can leave that up to her. Of course, even with Senator Vilma, I leave that up to her. Kasi ang sabi naman niya, I have no plans. No. Siguro, Mike, ganito lang kasimple yun eh. Even if you ask the administration candidates, lahat naman sila sasabihin nila they have no plans. So if our candidates have no plans, their candidates have no plans, for now, I said everything is fluid. But as I said, I thank and I congratulate Senator Sonny because he is steadfast and very clear that, of course, he would like to proceed to a higher office if possible. And he has a roadmap or plan for the development of the Philippines, which I think is very laudable at this point in time.
What about human rights lawyer Chal Jocno? He said he never aspired for those positions, while Representative Brother Eddie Villanueva's son, Senator Joel Villanueva, said he does not see his father running given their recent family tragedy.
Yeah, kay Attorney Chal, malinaw naman po yun. Sinabi lang niya, he did not aspire, pero hindi naman po niya sinabi hindi po siya lalahok sa proseso. No, yung kay Brother Eddie, it is Isan Joel who gave the statement and not Brother Eddie. But you have to remember, even on our event, which he gave his own statement, you even heard him give a message. So I think that that is telling that he is and willing to engage and join the process.
Now, let me go to former Senator Antonio Trillanes IV. It looks like, Senator, from the list announced by Isambayan last Saturday, only you and Vice President Lenny Robredo are very much open to running for president. Your nomination is not a surprise anymore, is it? What are your thoughts about the withdrawal of other nominees?
Ako po, kagaya nung sinasabi ni Attorney Howie, no, iniintindi natin yung kumbaga konteksto ng bawat prospective nominee. Meron silang mga iba't ibang konsiderasyon and the decision to run for higher office is especially at this time, ano, talaga mabigat na decision yan. Lalabang ka rito sa mga kagaya nila Duterte na determined to hold on to power, talagang sasaba ka sa gera dito. So naintindihan natin na medyo deliberate yung decision-making process nila.
But what made you decide, Senator, to make that decision as early as now, as early as a few months ago when you declared that you will run for president if Vice President Lenny Robredo does not?
Dahil na re-recognize natin yung problema ng ating bansa, no, this early, and unthinkable and palagay ko matinding kasalanan sa parte ng opposition na matalo kami by default. So while itong tinatawag na pakipot politics, uso yan before and it works. Pero sa ganitong mga panahon, hindi pwede kasi talagang maaga dapat ang preparation. Ano? Maraming problema ang Pilipinas at ngayon dapat pinag-aaralan na yon. Hindi pwedeng last minute magde-decide ka, tapos pag nanalo ka, wala ka naman alam. Hindi mo alam pa paano solusyonan yung problema. So it's time na gawin nating medyo mature yung ating pagpili ng mamumuno sa ating bansa. So yun lang, we just cannot lose by default.
What do you make of Vice President Lenny Robredo's not making a decision as of this moment whether to run for presidency? Is that a disadvantage to you? What are the negative consequences of that?
As it is, we're just assuming na ganun yung kumaga, we cannot do anything about it. It is what it is, so we'll just have to work around it. Yan ang magiging pananaw namin. Ano? We're waiting for her decision. And sabi ko nga, ako nirerespeto ko yung decision-making process na bawat isa. They can take as much time as they need. Pero kailangan dito buo ang loob, the proper time, at preparado, no? Academically and physically, emotionally, psychologically, because whether the decision or the declaration comes early or later, pero pagka nag-file na ng certificate of candidacy, ano na yan, mabilis na ang mga pangyayari niyan. So kailangan 100% committed dito kasi itong bansa ang pinag-uusapan natin eh. This is not peacetime politics anymore. Wartime politics ito.
Now, Attorney Calieja, let's talk about those who asked to be removed from the consideration for the nomination. Senator Nancy Binay cited personal reasons. What reasons did Manila Mayor Scott Moreno cite when he declined to be considered?
Well, we were just notified that he asked to be, his name to be set aside for the June 12 list. I think yun po as much as that, claro. So, and he also told us that he is supportive of the effort. So I think we have to give it to him. And I think his priority for the pandemic response to Manila and whatever needs his constituency. Then, as I said, no, and already stated also by Senator Sani, it is a personal decision whether they want to run or not, or whether they say it today or in the future. Pero yun nga, having in mind this is a presidential campaign, alam niyo naman, Mike, and I'm sure Senator Sani knows this very much, we have to prepare at least a year or more in advance. We cannot prepare overnight. No? So we, for its part, isang bayan is organizing, pero siyempre, in a standard better, it is faster and better to organize together.
Now, Attorney Calieja, I noticed that in most of the statements coming from those who you know, whom you nominated, some of them actually said they're not interested. They're not actually saying now we're giving way to this and that candidate because we support them. Is the messaging here not sending a message to the public that, you know, the opposition might not be united after all?
No, I don't think it is not united. I think, as I said, Mike, that all of them support the position of a united opposition. They all support the process. However, I think what is clear is that everything is fluid and open. When you say you are not interested or when you say there's no plans, but of course, all of this can change tomorrow or next week. That's why we are saying we are giving them time. We respect their time of discernment. But again, we have to realize that that time of discernment, sometime in October 1 to 8, which is the filing of the COMELEC candidacy, should really be clear, not only to us, but to the Filipino people, kasi kailangan magpa-file ka na ng candidacy. So maybe a few weeks or sometime before that, then it should be clear ano talaga yung intent. Because intent to run is one thing and announcement is another. So I think we just have to give them time, respect the time of discernment that they're asking, and continue the dialogue. What is important, as I said, Mike, is that these candidates and even other candidates, even for senator, we're still in dialogue with them, and all of them fully support the call for a united candidate against the administration in 2022.
Now, Attorney Calieja, isang bayan said it is still open to Senator Panfilo Lacson running under its ticket, but despite his position on the Anti-Terrorism Act, what about Senator Manny Pacquiao? Was he ever considered?
Well, put it this way, Mike. The consideration is not solely for the conveners, but of course, we get a lot of nominations, not only within the conveners, but mostly outside from the public. And all of them will be looked into, would be vetted and discerned properly by the group. However, what is important is that instead of looking at differences, we have to open and widen our scope or broaden the coalition and maybe look at what is common among us. I think that is the call of unity, no? Hindi pwedeng kami o tayo lang or a little group, no? That's why we have a broad alliance, a broad coalition, and as we grow and go into May 2022, we can make it bigger. So let's look at what is common. Let's look at what we can agree on, and let's look at how we can move forward towards 2022 and the development and recovery of the Philippines.
But Attorney Calieja, let me just ask this. Was there anyone within the coalition who nominated Senator Manny Pacquiao?
None in the coalition. However, we have received a lot of letters or text or communication from other groups and other individuals to consider Senator Manny.
All right. Now, let me go to Senator Trillanes. Senator, you just came from successive victories in the Court of Appeals against moves by the Duterte administration to revive cases against you. You have the rebellion charge dismissed in March. You have the coup d'etat charge dismissal affirmed last week. How will these help your candidacy?
Well, it would greatly reinforce our position that this administration has been using the law. It has been twisting the law, rather, in persecuting its critics. So I believe this would greatly help us in that part of the advocacy.
Senator, you have positioned yourself as an anti-Duterte figure. Is putting up an anti-Duterte platform enough to win you either the presidency or the vice presidency? We've seen that campaign of Ocho Derecho actually fail in 2019. What lessons are you taking from that?
Well, the context is different. Back in 2019, a lot of people have yet to see how incompetent Duterte really is. And this pandemic showed that. Now, whether the anti-Duterte position is going to make it or will be enough for us to win, I don't think so. Aside from the anti-Duterte position, well, in the first place, that is the essence of being an opposition, because you cannot be pro-Duterte and be opposition at the same time. So I believe we need first to define what the opposition is. So it's about policies. What are you against, Mr. Duterte? And there's a lot. Now, you cannot get away from that. Now, aside from that, but you need to start from that anti-Duterte position first. Then you expand to the general audience, the general electorate, about what you can offer for the country, for the development of the country, or the recovery of our national soul, if you may call it.
Well, talk about unity and trying to build a consensus here. You just came, Senator, you just came from a recent conviction for libel in a case filed by former Makati City Mayor Junjun Binay. How do you intend to reach out to the Binay camp to woo their votes? And in connection with this, recently you were also accused of red tagging on social media. How do you intend to reach out to the progressive bloc within that coalition?
I never red tag anybody, and they can check that. Now, if they are somebody is accusing me of doing that, and then that's false tagging in itself. They need to put up their evidence before they say so. As to the Binay family, well, I never, I don't take these things personally. It is an advocacy of mine, and it's not a parang rido or ubusan ng lahi approach. No. Kung sino nagkasala, iyon. I have a good relationship with Senator Nancy Binay, and it never got in the way of doing our work. So hindi po personalan to.
All right, let me go to Attorney Calieja. The anti-Duterte positioning was very apparent at Saturday's launch. How do you intend to woo Duterte supporters, or is this not part of your strategy? I note in the United States, the Democrats fielded Joe Biden is centrist, consensus builder, according to some, but this is to appeal to some in the Republican base. Will that strategy be helpful in our context?
Well, ang titignan mo, Mike, no, yung anti-Duterte, we did not hit on Duterte as a person. We hit the policies of the government that we feel the yung kunyari pamamalakad sa pandemic, yung EJK, yung West Philippine Sea. We're not saying he's a bad person or inutil siya. Those are his words. What we are saying is all these policies are not good for the Philippines. All the things that he did were not advantageous para sa atin, no? Kaya kailangan palitan na. And yung also yung dynasty issue niya, yung pagtakbo ng mga kanyang pamilya, hindi rin ito makakatulong sa akin. So all of what we're hitting are policies, nothing personal to him. Of course, he's the president. It may be looked at that way or some people may view it that way. Pero what Sambayan is saying, these policies, this how the government was run, was not beneficial for the Philippines. And what we will be presenting is an issue-based campaign that would focus on the recovery with the pandemic, recovery for the economy, and move this country beyond 2022, 2026, and over go over to 2050. So, ganun po, it would be a forward-looking platform of government centering on yung ating sinasabing tapat na pumumuno o good governance.
Attorney Galia, I just noticed that on Saturday, the name of Representative Nery Colmenares was not on the list of conveners. Is the Makabayan Bloc still solidly behind Isambayan?
Of course, the Makabayan Bloc is within Isambayan. Their rep now is Congressman Tonchi Inyo, because we have agreed that those in the conveners should not be running. I can say now that he is Congressman Nery is being considered in the senatorial slot for one of the 12 senators. That's why it would be not good if he would remain in the convener. So that's why he was replaced, or a Congressman Tinio is now sitting in the conveners instead of Attorney Nery Colmenares.
Has Representative Colmenares made a decision as to running for senator?
What is clear with us is that he has agreed to join the process for the selection for the Senate. Whether he would run or not, again, that is his personal decision. But we were informed that he is willing to have his name in the list of senators included.
Now, moving forward, Attorney Calieja, what would be the process be for the nomination? I mean, essentially, just have Vice President Lenny Robredo and Senator Trillanes very clearly interested in running. Is there still a need to go through a nomination process or selection process to come up with your nominees for President and Vice President?
Number one, when we say that we just have VP Lenin and Senator Sani, hindi po dapat sabihin we just have, because those are very competent and formidable names of individuals. We just need one candidate for president and one candidate for vice president. What we are doing, having a selection process, Mike, is giving the people the chance to put their to participate, no? Sumama po at mamili, and we broaden the selection process. That's all what we are saying. Just like, as you said, the Republican or the Democrats, they have a large field for the people to choose from, and then from that, we narrow them to one or two candidates, one for president and another for vice president. So that's what we're doing now. We're just saying we have a big field of individuals to choose from. We are broadening and not limiting to one group or groups, but to all groups. That's why we're asking that things are fluid, things can change, things can add, or it can remain the same. Whatever it is, I think what is important is that all of these groups, all of these candidates agree to the process and to the purpose of a united opposition. At sama-sama naman po sila na nag-agree na magsusuporta sa isa't isa come election day.
Right. Now, Senator Trillanes, let's talk about the timing. Because I know, unlike the administration, the opposition has to work on the grassroots movement. It has to work on its coordination with the LGUs and other units to be able to put up a formidable defense against the administration. How important do you think is timing for the opposition?
It's very important because if we recognize how high the stakes are in 2022, then it's just our responsibility to prepare to win in 2022. Because again, for some, and I believe the 2022 elections is the most important elections in our history after 1986. And with stakes that high, then we just have to make sure that we have to win. And in order to win, you need to prepare and prepare well and prepare early, sana. But it is what it is, so we'll just have to work around it. So once that decision is made, we just need to catch up. Yun lang. And hindi naman dapat tayo nagka-catch up kasi nga dehado ng laban, dapat talagang mas porsigido at mas maaga yung opposition. We have a mountain to climb. Kaya kailangan simulan na yung pag-akyat na yun.
All right. On that note, thank you, gentlemen, for joining us this morning. Isang Bayan co-convener, Attorney Howard Calieja, and former Senator Antonio Trillanes IV.